I mean, can you talk about Allison's motivation to make a secret deal with her father? I mean, that is, that's some bad stuff shitty. There.
Yeah. I mean, I think we spend the entire season with Allison kind of spiraling the drain with the loss of Claire and Ray. And then dear old Reggie kind of opens up a window and is like, hey, you could change all of that and get not only Claire back, but potentially Ray as well. And I think at that point, she's so done with her family and she's so done with Victor and she's so done with all of them that she's willing to risk it all.
Yeah, it feels like you kind of open a door and go through it without a lot of regret. Were you keeping that kind of layered underneath in a way? Because it is a horrible thing to do, to betray your whole family.
Yeah, I think in the moment where they make that deal, I think a lot, it's really malicious on her part and also very selfish. But then I think from that moment on, she starts to see the repercussions of that, like Luther dying and not really knowing what Reggie's plan is and kind of feeling like, oh, okay, it might be spiraling out of control. And now like the marbles are loose and she can't really gather them up fast enough to kind of get ahead of it.
Yeah.
But I think she still is kind of, that's still in the back of her mind that, you know, this is his plan. If she just trusts him, she'll have Claire and Ray.
Yeah.
Even regardless of how devastating it is and watching, you know, her brother die and the world fall apart and the people that she loves get hurt.
Yeah. It's a beautiful transition you make as you go from that point of ruthlessness to realizing, oh no, what did I do? Yeah, it almost catches up with you.
Yeah, totally. Totally. Yeah. I don't think I really saw that coming until we were like actually shooting us finding Luther. And just kind of, you know, I think I obviously had like read the scripts and you know, it hadn't marinated yet until we were actually shooting some of these scenes, how much she just is kind of blindly trusting Reggie, and she gets kind of caught up in this like, and there's nobody she can talk to about it. There's nobody she can, she just has to play
dumb.
You
put yourself in your own corner.
Yeah.
Emmy, Allison's realization about her loss of Ray and Claire and how they don't exist in this timeline was, it was incredibly heartbreaking, and how you played it was so beautiful. How did you approach portraying that very unique version of grief?
I think I just tried as well as I could to put myself in her shoes and kind of use the source material of the entire second season, of everything that Allison had kind of gone through and the traumas that she collected from being in the 60s, and her love, her deep and immense love for Ray, and kind of finally finding herself without her family and without her powers for the first time, and then making the choice to leave him to find her daughter and to prioritize her relationship with her daughter, and truly losing that. It's like, that's devastating. I can only imagine. And so I actually printed out the little girl Coco who plays Claire. I have a ton of photos of her and I from the couple times that we've been able to work together. And so I had them like all over my trailer, and pictures of me and Yusuf, who plays Ray. Just a kind of constant reminder of like the family and the reasons that, you know, got Allison to where she is just every day at work. So that was really helpful.
Yeah, there were so many layers to your performance.
Yeah.
And you got a double dose of it this season because of your storyline with Victor, which was so heart-wrenching too. How hard was that to play?
I mean, I really enjoyed season 3 of Allison because she, in her own way, got to kind of be the villain of the Umbrellas. I think she, this is a version of Allison we've never really seen before. She's usually kind of the center and the one that will go around and bring everybody together when everybody starts to kind of fall off the train. And she's always there to like reach, you know, outreach her hand and get everybody back on board. And I think this is the first season where she's like, you know what? I'm actually done with that. Yep. So I think it was really fun to play the op and just a version of her that we've never really seen before. And to dive into her anger and to dive into her kind of her trauma and her really fractured mental state.